Oh, look, it's a doggy. A fine-looking pooch with a curiously intelligent look in his eyes. Dog tag around his neck reads, Laddie. I can talk to Laddie? Oh my god, that's his face? Is that necessary? Is that the image you had to go with? That's horrifying. What's that, Laddie? You can smell Alexi on me? Yeah, that's not very surprising. And I'm doing it by woofing at him. What's that, Laddie? Yes, Alexi gave me this note for you. What's that, Laddie? You want us to take this rock back to him as a reply? What's that, Laddie? He'll know what it means. Okay. What is my nightmare? Alright, so... Apparently Laddie with the horrifying fucking gremlin face is the soulmate. And so now I'm supposed to go take a rock back down. We'll get around to that on the way out, I'm sure. The woman appears to be Native American. She has hard, proud features and wears worn wet leather clothes and an assortment of feathers in her hair.
Thank you, Desert Rangers. I have heard that your tribe brings justice to the wastes. Then bring justice here and free me from this cage. I would travel with you if you would have me. There is much I can help you with, and you can help me as well.
Oh, she can join the crew. Can I have more than 4 people in my crew, or do I have to substitute someone out? Highpool is holding you unjustly?
They speak lies of me. They say I am a spy for the ones you call the Wrecking Crew. I am not. I came not to raid, but to trade.
What do you have to trade? I come bearing seeds from my native land, ready to trade for cargo we do not possess. These seeds are strong. They grow with little water. With them, your lands can thrive again. But through their though their crops are burned, these water hoarders will not trade. Instead, they call me spy and put me in their cage and allow their juvies to torment me. So, those juvies were giving you a hard time?
Pig-faced little punks. They all need a serious spanking. Crap. Did I say that out loud? Oh, hell. So much for the Noble Savage Act.
Yay! She's just gonna talk like a normal person. So you're not a noble savage.
Hey, I'm still a 100% red-blooded, all-American Native American, just like I said. But all that talking like an 800-year-old wise woman? Well, not to be insulting, but you foreigners expect that stuff. I can get double the price for my seeds when I do the whole "let me teach you the old ways" speech.
I'm kind of happy, because that was getting a little insensitive for something that's supposed to be probably in the future-ish or something. Who are you calling a foreigner?
If you're not Indian, then your people weren't born here, and that makes you a foreigner. Sorry, Kemosabe, that's just the way it is.
What kind of cargo do you need?
There are many things that we require. Water, livestock, medicine, books.
So, you have no affiliation with the Wrecking Crew?
No, I told you. They're just a bunch of crazies dressed in tin cans. Real smart in this heat. No wonder their brains are fried. Hey, if you want to go after them, I could track them easy.
Oh, she would help me get there. My revenge trip. How do you feel about the Desert Rangers?
You guys are supposed to be the good guys. I hope that's the truth.
What can we do for you?
Well, see, I'm not from around here. My tribe lives beyond the wall of radiation to the south. But a couple of months back, the winds shifted, and a low rad path opened up between our lands and yours. It looked like it was going to be stable, so me and some pals decided we'd come north to trade. It didn't go well. We got jumped by raiders our second week here, and my friends... I was the only one who escaped. But when I turned around to go back home, the winds had changed again, and the path, it was gone. The way back to my family, my tribe, my kids. Just gone. I hung around, waiting, but it never opened up again, and I didn't know if it ever would. So I decided the best thing I could do was see as much of this side of the wall as I could. You know, collect new wisdom to take back to my people. If I can ever get back. Of course, the first place I came was here, so not so much wisdom yet. But I'm hopeful.
Well, that's a bummer. She's separated from her kids. I don't have proof that she's not doing anything wrong, but it seems she doesn't really seem like she'd be a member of the wrecking crew, and it's not at all surprising that people would be bigoted against any sort of outsider. I mean, they haven't shown me much courtesy, and I literally saved their lives.
Which is why I'd like to travel with you. I know I was putting on an act just now, but I really can do everything I said. I can track, tame animals, heal you, help you find water, and I can handle myself in a fight. What do you say? Can I join your party? Great. Then get me out of here and let's get going.
Yay, we're making a new friend. Oh, hey, I just noticed that my little roster on the bottom of the screen, it shows my four party members, but then it has what looks like three more slots. So maybe I can get three more party members then without having to substitute anyone out. It makes sense if you could recruit new people without actually losing people. Having a whole extra person could actually be really handy for combat in general, aside from having brand new skills. And it makes sense that the game would let you recruit more people because the sheer number of skills that they want you to have is actually really extensive. So it seems unreasonable for four people to have them all. So it makes sense that you'd be able to get more. The folks in this house never have to go far for water. Yep, because everything here is water. This building has an official look to it, like it was built the same time as the rest of the dam. High pull underground. Alright. A sign above the door here used to read cistern. It has now been crossed out and reads irrigation. Alright, so that's the main entrance I'm supposed to take, probably to go underground for the pipes. I was born in High Pool, and I'll most likely drown here as well. They specifically talk about drowning before just straight up anything else. Oh, interestingly, this character's a prisoner here. If I hadn't saved them, they'd all be dead, right? So the prisoner would probably be dead. I wonder if the irrigation place probably has its own NPC you can recruit to even things out. Looks like a nice place to dine al fresco. Hey, Garouf, come here, girl. Who are you talking to? You have a pet around here? See, do I have anywhere else to investigate? Should I talk to him about his pet? Oh, hey, rangers. Thanks for saving us from those marauding wrecking crew jerks, I guess. Oh, he's all prissy and fancy and smoking and stuff. You guess? You don't seem very enthusiastic. Oh, sorry. I'm just kind of sad. In all the commotion, my dog ran away. She must be somewhere in town, but I've looked everywhere and I can't find her. She's my best friend. Tell us about your dog. She's the best. Every evening, she greets me when I come home from tending the crops down below the dam. She hops up on her back legs and bounces around, and she has the funniest bark, Garouf. So distinctive, it became her name. My mom called her Lucinda when she was a puppy, but that never really fit. Garouf was much more appropriate. Can we do anything to help? Really? You do that? Wow. Maybe the stories I've heard about you guys aren't quite accurate. I really need someone to help me cover more ground here. Take her Busy Bee. It's her favorite chew toy. You can use that to settle her down when she's temperamental. What happened during the attack? A mortar shell landed just outside the house and she panicked. I think she just was scared out of her wits. I've only seen her like that once before when a water main blew. The only thing that calmed her down was her Busy Bee chew toy. It's her favorite. Thanks for helping, rangers. I just know that we'll find her. Okay, his portrait does not at all match what his character model looks like. Oh well. That's just something you have to get used to in these games. From playing Shadowrun, I learned a lot of that. It's like, yep, those portraits are not really going to match much. It takes too much work to make a portrait as opposed to make another character model from a character creator. A large, sturdy building in the town hall written on the door. So this must be town hall. Maybe that's how I get the get insight about the leadership here, and maybe figure out how to get, what's her name, saved? Vulture? The smell of musty maps, guidebooks, and camping supplies fills the air. Harold said, "Welcome to Adler's Dry Goods, friends. If you don't see it, ask. I got most anything you need. Hopefully you got a shotgun." Oh, come on, Silas. There isn't much more. There's much more than a scratch. So this is the doctor. Oh, can he? Oh, this is the doctor we heard about. Can I look at him directly? Dr. Warner's clinic is overflowing with patients. Everywhere you look, you see broken bones, bullet wounds, third-degree burns, and shrapnel cases. The doc's doing the best he can, but a skilled surgeon might be able to lend a hand. Ooh, I have a skilled surgeon. Doc, let's talk. A man with sandy blonde hair and a careworn smile tends to wounded hypo citizens in a makeshift trauma ward outside his office. You look like you've been living well and staying low when bullets fly. Unlike these poor folk here. Doesn't look like you need me to patch you up. What can I do for you? We're alright. How can we help you? Well, I don't need any help, not personally. Though, if you got any skill with triage, I wouldn't say no to a helping hand. But the bigger concern is that those wreckers made a mess of our irrigation system. Don't know if you're handy with that kind of thing, but Kate Preston could sure use a hand down in the cistern. What do you think of Kate Preston? Well, she's no good with plumbing, but she'd make a better mayor than Bergen. Wouldn't rely so much on the boot and the stick, if you know what I mean. How'd the mayor die? Wrecker shot him right through the neck, then he fell from the walls. I tried to save him, but he was too far gone. There was nothing I could do. What are your thoughts on the wrecking crew? Why everyone thinks they can kill their way to a good life, I don't know. Growing things, having kids, healing the world, that's the only way. Bergen? I think he's a good man at heart, but the world has treated him harshly, and he's returning the favor. Just fine as a second in command, but he's too angry to be an effective leader. Tell me about the irrigation system. Works like a charm when somebody hasn't blown it up. Store the water, use the pressure of the drop to bring the water to the crops. But those wreckers have gummed up the work something awful. You can heal us? Sure, if you need it, just say the word. You look fine now. When you get wounded, come back here and I'll patch you up. Good luck, Rangers. I could probably help you with these characters over here that are wounded. Using surgeon skills. Come on. They're not gonna straight up die if I failed, will they? That'd be a bummer. Thanks, Rangers. I'm feeling better, but not quite ready to get up. Nicely done, Rangers. Keep that up and the town might start thinking more highly of you. Alright, that's cool. I'm a little worried that I might kill somebody. I'll just quick save. Yay. Just in case. Oh, 76%, that's way better. Come on. Let's succeed at surgery again. What's wrong with you? Stay away if you can't help. I feel bad now. Shit. It's not usually a good idea to swish someone's internal organs around like that. The patient is flatlined. I just killed somebody? Oh, do I dare save scum? Is this a save scumming situation? I feel like a terrible person for that. I wonder what my... Are we gonna win again? That's weird that it said 26% the first time and I lost. I succeeded. Ouch, that stung. Refreshing, though. We succeeded. See, we're amazing. Look how awesome we are. We only killed one guy. 100%? That's great. Come on. Yay, your tender ministrations have renewed my flagging constitution. That's our terminology. Let's see. Can I target this character? I can't look over here, apparently. No, target the one over here. Okay, fine, target this one then. 91%. What could go wrong? He's dead. he was all like, it's just a scratch, and now he's dead. Aww. Well, at least it wasn't a critical failure. It just means nothing happened. Come on. Yeah, on. Pain's gone. Think I can finally get to sleep. Look at me saving everyone like a badass. Can I not target this guy? What's going on? Any feedback on the fact that I'm saving your patients for you, you incompetent doctor? I can't highlight him, damn it. He's too close to the other character, Reverend Witcher problems. If you're gonna work in my infirmary, you need to be more careful, Rangers. A misplaced suture kills as surely as a bullet. Anyway. Not even a slight remark about the fact that I saved some people? Aww. That's a bummer. Are these extra med kits? Those are my only remaining medical supplies. If you really need them, I really need them to look up after the folks here. This large crate has a heavy lock. It likely contains some valuable medical supplies, so you can totally pilfer his supplies. That's cruel. Alright, well, too bad about the critical failure, despite the high success chance. Okay, I can't really... Text is going way too fast now. Alright, along the right wall of the main room, a store has been set up. A few swap meat tables piled high with junk, an ancient fridge, and some bulkier items against the wall. Hanging down is a hand-painted sign that reads, Adler's Dry Goods, Hypel's Lowest Prices. In the middle of it all, a man sits at a lawn chair, swatting flies with a fly swatter. I don't see a lawn chair. You lied to me. He seems utterly unconcerned with the damage his town has suffered. A small engine lies on the ground, looking like it might fit into a pumping machine nearby. Well, sounds like I want to get that then. Are you pilfering supplies that people need, dick? I can't talk to that guy, only that guy over here. Yeah, he's not a lawn chair. Which is kind of weird, because there's totally lawn chairs in this game. I've seen one on top of that one RV. So it's weird they wouldn't use it here. An ancient aerosol can. What does Jerry Curl mean? Oh, Jerry Curl. The big contraption is a patchwork machine. You recognize a pump? Lime-crusted pipes go under the floor. You deduce that this is a water purification device. It looks broken. The gaping hole beside the pump leads you to think that it could be fixed with a new engine. Oh, you mean like the engine that guy has? That dick over there? Alright, let's talk to him. If I can highlight him correctly. No, not that. Him. There we go. A small man with sharp eyes and soft hands. He flicks a fly away with a swatter, then gazes deeply into your wallet. How did he see my wallet? Also, where's his fly swatter? He's holding a pistol. Also, where's his lawn chair? Howdy, folks. What can I do for you? I got guns, ammo, armor, medical supplies, and smokes. I'll also take almost anything you got to trade. Snake squeezins, scrap metal, broken weapons, odds and ends. You want to buy snake squeezins? Yeah. I usually buy them from a traveling salesman from Nail Romad, but he was a little short on stock the last time he came through, so I could use some more. Who was this traveling salesman? His name's Sammy Haz, from Rail Nomad. Makes a regular circuit around the waste, selling the sweet, sweet poison. Told me he was with Ace when Ace was murdered. Oh, that's good to know then. That could be information about what we're going after. Do you know anything more about the murder? Sammy didn't say much about it, seemed spooked about the whole thing. You want to talk to him, might find him in Rail Nomad. That's where he goes to resupply. What's with the big pumps behind us? Ah, that old thing. Story goes that the Rangers actually fixed it up for us a decade and a half back. Not sure I believe it, but it broke down for good about a year ago. It runs, but it just spews the most foul cloud of black you ever smelled. Now I'm stripping it for parts. Already got the engine pulled out. The bit should make for a pretty penny. They're just taking things and selling it? Alright, what brands of smokes do you carry? Got all brands, choose your poison. But I got something special too. Recently traded for a carton of genuine pre-apocalypse coffin nails. Best smokes money can buy. Even after 150 years of preservatives, keep that tobacco as fresh as the day it was picked. Truly, The wonders of the ancients were miraculous. You want to buy some? What do you have to trade? I think someone said they wanted coffin nails earlier. Alright, first of all, let's look at for things to sell, probably. A chew toy. No, let's look for all the junk I have. Here we go. Junk chest plates. These are worth something, right? Oh yeah, sell junk button. Bam. That didn't get rid of the chest plates, though, interestingly enough. Will they also sell those? Alright. Ballad of Bobby and Rex. Coffin nails. I got those. I'm good. Cool. Sickle? Sickle's worth something. It might be worth selling. Assault rifle. I'll probably teach someone to use assault rifle just so that I have the options for all of our different ammo types. Don't want to run into too many situations where we just flat out start running out of ammo altogether. We do have a fair amount of pistol shots left, which is good news. Where's my current supply of money? I have 400 apparently. I mean 500, which is good. A small gray stone, that's a quest item. The big gun's worth 21. This rust bucket's worth 41. Sickle's worth 45, interestingly. Huh. Let's look at what we can buy from him. So, most interested in what I can get for Sally, probably. We can get a shotgun of some kind. Let's see, goat hide armor. Cured goat hide armor shaped into armor. Cured goat hide shaped into armor. It's heavy, provides minimal protection, and worst of all, it stinks like goat. It makes you slower, but gives you 3 armor, requires 5 strength. So it's only useful for certain characters, like basically just Sally. So Sally could use it to get slightly more armor than they currently have, but it'd make her slower. As opposed to a leather jacket, which does not make you slower, but has one less armor. Sniper rifle ammo costs... Is that 105? That better be for the whole goddamn stack. 15 shots for $100. Shotgun shells? How many do we... We have some amount for her. Right now, we have 23. So I currently have more than they're selling. Assault rifle... Herbicide. Interesting name for an energy weapon. Designed by Dr. Ryan Urbison as a handheld weed killer for giant weeds, a nickname Herbicide... In his honor, the good doctor thought it would provide equally effective against giant mushrooms and thus changed its name to fungicide. Unfortunately, Urbison was killed by an exploding pod person before he was able to test his hypothesis. Uses energy cells. Energy weapons cannot jam or inflict critical hits, but deal bonus damage to targets with conductive armor. So, 2.5 damage versus conductive enemies. Doesn't seem like it's chance to hit changes ever, which is interesting to have access to. Sawed-off shotgun. What it lacks in range, it makes up for in spread. While it doesn't pack the punch of its longer brother, you can almost hit enemies behind you. Oh, so it's super inaccurate and spready then. Is the longer brother around here, maybe? Grip tape. Get a grip, man. Seriously, it helps a lot in swinging a weapon around faster. You lose 1 attack AP. Oh, it costs 1 less AP it costs you 1 less AP to actually to attack. It's only used on melee weapons? Interesting. So you could have Sally use less AP to attack. That's probably a big deal. I probably want to grab that. Short barrel weapon mod. I'm gonna have to learn weaponsmithing soon to be able to use these. Gun modification decreases the range, but significantly increases, chance to hit. For the precise gunslinger who is not afraid to get in close and personal. Useful on pistols. Let's see. -4 maximum range, -2 optical range. +4% chance to hit. Compelling. Might have to come back for this one or something. Oh, more pocket med kits. So they're 20 each. So I can buy all of them for 180, which is really tempting because I could use more healing kits for sure. That might be where my money goes ultimately. Let's grab that shotgun like planned. Could use that. Get some sniper ammo. Because I don't really have any. We're down to 236. Do I blow the rest on that, do I grab that weapon tape for 90? Let's do it. I'm like 1 point away from being able to teach someone weaponsmithing. Not sure who I'll go with, but it'll be worthwhile. Did I not buy those field medic packs? What did I just buy? Oh right, I've got the gun and two ammo types. So I still need to buy the medical kits. As many as I can afford, which in this case is like that many. It's nice. Alright, well I'm fresh out of money. I think I needed that though. Alright. Bye now, tell your friends. So I'm pretty sunk as far as money go, but I think that was handy. Now my character has a shotgun instead of some garbage, instead of a stick. Should I just sell the stick? Oh, it's actually worth something. I don't know if I'm gonna do anything with that. Let's just go ahead and sell that then. Sell garbage stick. Yep, 39. That's handy. I can get those extra healing kits out of that. There we go. That was a nice change of pace. I apparently need those because we took a lot of damage that last fight. And if not, I'll make savings in the long run by having a bunch of them available. Let's see. Weapon grip, let's give that over to... Give that to the character that's likely to use it eventually. Shotgun ammo, sniper ammo. Give that to our sniper. All of it. Alright, we're good to go now. Anyone have weird errant ammo sitting around where they shouldn't? So you got the heavy gun. What do you currently have? Sniper rifle, assault rifles. Let's equip the heavy gun as your primary. Or actually, it should be your secondary. Let's see. So, secondary, which lets me go back to the sniper rifle to put in my primary. There we go. I'm going to want to reload that. So we have a hunting rifle and an M12, because we went and gave him the skills for using heavy weapons. So we'll go ahead and give this assault rifle back to Scary Sally to carry. Assault rifle and heavy ammo. Maybe I won't want to use an assault rifle. It might be redundant if it uses the same ammo as heavy weapons, and I already trained in that. So that might be something to sell for more gains. Because I might want to get a better armor piece for my other character. Alright, does everyone else have what they need? Right, two assault rifles worth 40 each. Sickle. I think everyone's pretty much got what they're supposed to have right now. Yeah. I'm thinking. Maybe we do change over. Let's see, that armor would be handy. Costs 125. I could use that for my other close range character. So, let's make a trade then. Two assault rifles would get me 82. This would get me 127. Is that enough? That is enough. Alright, I'm gonna make this trade. Don't think I need that many spare assault rifles sitting around. As opposed to the opportunity to get more bonus armor for one of my other close range characters that could probably need it. I'm glad we could make these trades. Alright. Plus two armor indeed. Very handy to have. Alright, so my two closest range characters are now armored. I'm quite happy to have that. Let's go ahead and make an actual manual save. So I can keep track of what I'm doing here. I think we're done here. What's the deal with this thing over here? A small motor that could be used in a water purification pump. Are they gonna freak out if I grab it? No? I thought that would be considered stealing, but they don't seem to care. I could use the small engine here. Alright, so ultimately, get a few things together and we could fix this place. God damn it, Rangers, I was stripping that thing for parts. Now it's gonna be belching smoke until it runs out of whatever runs it on. Get out of my shop. The water purifier smoke sputters and generates clouds of air with some noxious carcinogens. Aww. I feel bad. I thought I could help with something. I guess if anything's gonna fix that thing, I'd need another thing to help fix it, right? That I don't have right now. I may have just done that may have been a dick move. Oh well. It's hard to be that bothered if I piss people off, because they were already mad at me. Scrap. Got more scrap. And handgun ammo. And another library card. More junk for the pile. Well, if it ain't Raiders, it's Rangers. Spits on the ground. Nobody's in this tower, no need. The wreckers never got this far. They just might have a juvenile delinquent problem in this town. Which is impressive, because there's not very much town to have a problem in. Alright, so there's an obvious way to go underground, but I'm gonna check out this other path, because it might lead to some kind of cool secret or something. Let's go underground. Maybe I'll find a nice surprise.